Hare Krishna. Welcome all of you. So we are on lesson 5 today. Many of these things that I speak in each lesson, there'll be little overlap with the previous lessons. And you should not think that such a repetition has no purpose. Purposefully I connect, and there is a purpose for repeating many of these things. So today, even though we have spoken about the background consciousness and the foreground consciousness, or the background mind and the foreground mind, or content in the background and content in the foreground. The reason why this is important, because the content in the background, there's a different way of dealing with it to make it desirable. And the content of the foreground, there's a different, again, the method is different. How to make it desirable? The foreground content is managed by the conscious mind, the active conscious mind, where our free will is actually operating to chant, come here, and to task. So, in the case of background mind, our current free will is not active. Free will is always operating in the foreground. So the background mind, if free will is not operating during japa, then what makes things, how can the content in the background be under control as we desire? How can we bring it as we desire? How can we have the right kind of feelings, faith, knowledge in the background, which is all very much required for a good quality japa? So this differentiation between the two is very important. Many of the concepts I'll be repeating again and again, and that is being done with a purpose, so that, you know, they are actually very common. They are no complicated concepts. Very common observations of how our mind works in dealing with different things. Because we concluded that the discipline japa depends a lot on the mind. Today I'll be talking about module 5, which is basically talking about the foreground mind and background mind. Please don't get, you know, scared of, you know, what is this complexity? Background mind, foreground mind, I have not heard anywhere. But whether you heard or not, these things exist in our system. In fact, I got this clue from Prabhupada's quote, where it says, the Supreme Person is realized through devotional service, which is backed by full knowledge and detachment from material association. Devotional service, which is based on the foreground of full knowledge combined with the detachment from material association, and which is fixed by oral reception of Vedanta Shruti, is the only perfect method by which the seriously inquisitive student can realize the absolute truth. So I was, for several years, I was trying to figure out what does Prabhupada mean by this foreground of his knowledge, or foreground of knowledge and detachment. So that is where very clearly we can see that when we do something, the activity that we are doing with our free will, it is in the foreground of the mind. That means there is an active conscious mind where activity, I am using my free will to chant and to hear, all those things, or to move the beads, all this activity I am doing. And there you have to use our free will. Now there is something background. We yesterday discussed that there are so many things in the background which determine the quality of japa, the knowledge about this savior, knowledge about this process of seva, faith, and intention, desire, purpose. So these are all the things that are there. We don't have to use our free will for that. It is in the background. Since japa finally depends upon the quality of activity in the foreground, distinctly chanting and sharply hearing, and also it depends on the quality of content in the background mind. So the content in the background mind, during japa, by using our free will, we don't bring it up. Oh, I have to now think of Krishna. I have to bring in faith. All those things you don't have to do, because that dealing with the background mind is completely a different game. Because when we do japa, we always think, normally by default tendencies, when I am doing an activity, I should do that activity perfectly at that time. Then activity is perfect. No, this misunderstanding you remove. Even though you may be very perfectly, sharply hearing and attentively chanting or whatever it may be, everything that possible you are doing in the foreground mind, correctly doing in the foreground mind, but still, what is in the background determines the quality of your japa. The background mind gives meaning to the activity in the foreground. Another way to understand background and foreground mind is just like there is a stage on which, let's say, there is a theater stage where there is a play going on. So the stage is like the foreground. And then there are so many backdrops. Let's say the context is that of a house. Some conversation, some act, the players are talking in the theater, the players are talking in the setting of a house. Immediately there is a backdrop of a house. So it immediately gives us a context for our activity. So any activity we have, always there is a context behind us. And the context is something that is in japa. The context is to be prepared, not at the time of japa, but it has to be prepared not on a daily basis before the japa, but it is a one-time preparation of what is the holy name, how he descends, how is the avatara, how is the avatara, you know, what are the things that the avatara does, how does it come into our heart, how all these things, this knowledge, then especially in the case of japa, So many different faiths are required. This faith, at the time of japa, you cannot produce. It will just trigger. You don't consciously produce the faith. Krishna is non-different from his name. You don't produce that at the time of japa. If you have enough, if you have done enough off japa work, when I say off japa, O-F-F, off japa work, then automatically as soon as the sound Krishna comes, the thought feeling that he is God, God is before me, he is his supremacy, he is a supreme Lord, all these come as a feeling automatically. So therefore, perfection of japa means perfection of foreground activity during japa and lot of activity off japa time. Now, off japa time, one good thing about off japa time preparation is you are creating once in a lifetime. For instance, if it has all entered your subconscious mind, the thought feeling, there is a feeling and the thoughts behind that feeling, the thoughts that lead to that feeling, that bhavana, if it settles in our subconscious mind, you don't have to do it every time. You don't, your pre-japa work or off-japa work can be done in, let's say you get familiar with all these concepts and the feelings that come out of these thoughts. In 1 year, if you get, then rest of the life it is going to serve you. So that is exactly why I am saying that this reading the japa modules is actually off japa time work. Again, read, try to understand that, let it settle inside our consciousness. Knowing very well that quality of japa depends a lot upon the background mind, content in the background mind, the facts that are there in the background mind, the feelings that are there, the faith that is there, the intention, desire and purpose that is there. And feelings mean so many feelings, a series of them, respect, love, surrender, gratitude. So all these things, if imagine, just like I spend money to buy an air conditioner. It always gives me comfort till it breaks down or something. But I don't have to buy every day an air conditioner. In the same way, pre-japa work, every day you don't have to do. But now as a practice, you have to do to begin with. And send all of them into the subconscious by repeated contemplation. And then the moment you lift your bead bag, everything will come. It will be triggered. Moment you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. All that bhavana, it will start triggering one after the other. The faith will start triggering. So your absorption, your attention is fully on the foreground. And the background gives a meaning to that activity. So once again, because we are trying to control our mind with respect to disciplining japa. And therefore, I am once again stressing the way to control the foreground mind is by action during japa. And the way to prepare the background mind is to work not during japa, but before. You have to prepare by reading, hearing, contemplating all these things. So effort is to be put in two places. Never think that if I chant very nicely, then that will be the best japa. The 2 hours that you, at the time of 2 hours of japa, the quality is not guaranteed by what you do only in those 2 hours. The background and foreground mind is very, very easy to understand. I'll give you an example. Just like if you're sitting in your house and somebody knocks the door and you open the door, you see your neighbor is standing there. And as soon as you see the neighbor, what happens? You do not know what to do immediately. As soon as you see the neighbor, immediately in your background, your subconscious loads the identification of your and all the qualities and what kind of person he is. Everything is loaded in your background. Because that is loaded in your background, now that background knowledge and perception about that neighbor gives you direction. Now what your foreground mind should do? What did you do? Ah, please come in, sir. Please sit down. Suppose in your background mind doesn't recognize who it is. Let's say your brain is damaged. You don't recognize. You just stare at him. You have no direction what to do. So you recognize him in the background mind. Immediately, please come in, sir. You make him sit. Let us say after he sits, all of a sudden he says, see, I need your help. Yesterday there was burglary in my house and some thieves came in, took this and went. Can you help me? You know. Oh, as soon as you hear that situation, immediately something gets loaded in your background. What is that? All your experience. What is the context? What is stealing means? What is burglary means? All you have learnt all these things. Immediately it comes up and then also immediately you know that all your knowledge about going to police, filing the complaint and all those things. So you will respond. Yes, yes, definitely. Let's say bring a paper. Let me write down the complaint and we'll go to the police station. I'll come with you. In the foreground action you take based on background. So in japa also, now you can more clearly understand the two components that constitute quality of japa. Foreground activity, background preparation. So, in the foreground, some of the minimum things, background, some of the minimum things that in the initially itself is required is, as I said yesterday, you cannot forget the savior who is being served. You can never forget, even as a neophyte, which means you should understand that japa means serving the Lord who is before me. That has to settle in your subconscious mind. It is not an impersonal activity. It is not a process of moving the bead and moving the tongue and all those things. Primarily, it is a relationship. Japa is a relationship with the person who is before me. So that's the first thing that we have to again and again think about it. And you'll be surprised that I'll be spending lot of time. Almost my 25 modules are just dedicated towards introducing Nama Prabhu. About the savior. I've talked about savior. Different aspects. Different, you know, which increases our Shraddha, increases our faith. Yes, it's a reality that Krishna is before me. When you read that again and again, you hear that, you know, from Ramamurtha Prabhupada repeatedly saying that it is Krishna himself. Then it will settle in our subconscious mind. And automatically, our foreground activity of chanting and hearing will develop the proper meaning. And then later on, the question of, you know, we can, as I said yesterday, soulful japa is like an orchestra. We can train our mind systematically to trigger, how to trigger surrender, how to trigger. For instance, you know, how can you have so many simultaneous feelings? You can have one main feeling at a time. Just like an orchestra has different musical instruments. You can do one full mala simply with the feeling of gratitude alone. The Lord is in the background. Full one mala you can do with gratitude. One full mala you can do with surrendering your existence to Him. One full mala with, you can just do with, you know, feeling of great respect for the Nama Prabhu. One full mala you can do with Preeti. Preeti means desire to please the Nama. So like that, just see, so many possibilities are there. You should get excited about it. You have to prepare your subconscious mind for it. So there is some little effort is there in triggering what you want, in what attitude, what mood today you want to chant this mala, that mala. Little role of foreground mind is there. Free will is there, even in triggering the background mind. But largely, your free will is constant, is completely absorbed in the activity of offering service, the chesta of hearing, chesta of repeating, all those things. So, now one of the things that all this knowledge helps you in catching your wrong japas. For instance, you know, if you are saying, if you are chanting and you are philosophizing, Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead, He is all attractive, and in all these things you are philosophizing, your attention goes there. You have to touch the Lord. Your attention has to touch the Lord. That is okay. That then without chanting also you can do smaranam. Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead, all those things. But by smaranam, you cannot touch the Lord. Unless you are very pure. You need to understand this, very important. Shravanam, Kirtanam, all the nine processes of devotion service is there. Including deity worship. It requires a certain kind of a qualification to get connected to the deity form. Smaranam. It requires certain level of purity of the mind to get connected. Simply chanting and hearing, no pre-qualification. As long as you have attention, you are connected to Krishna. That is the reason why you said that attention connection should not go philosophizing or even thinking of preaching activities, what to do, you know, tomorrow, all those things. That also, you do it afterwards. Why? This is a time for us to connect with Krishna. So, again, want you to feel great relief that though foreground activity is a daily effort to chant and hear and connect with Krishna, as far as background is concerned, once you settle, once you have, you get to know about Nama Prabhu, you get attached to Nama Prabhu, the feelings start, the feelings go from you to the Nama Prabhu, then automatically you will see there is a relationship with Nama Prabhu and you don't have to again and again do it. No work to be done at all as far as background mind is concerned. It's a one-time investment. Whereas, foreground activity, day to day you have to be attentive. You can train your mind, but even if you train your mind, you will see that mind has its own limit. Some days when you are very disturbed, even your trained mind is not strong enough. Those disturbing emotions will take away your attention. You are not able to. So day to day, according to Kala, different days, our internal atmosphere is our internal psychological atmosphere is different every day. Therefore, we have to, you know, to give attention is a challenge, is an ongoing challenge of japa. Background challenge is one-time challenge. We have to feed that. We have to understand the theology of the holy name. We have to understand the what holy name is expecting. Because it is a seva, you need to know the mind of the savior. What does savior expect? God is before me. What does he expect? And then I can try to meet that expectation and please him. So this is the main thing. I want all of you to understand the effort that we need to put for both foreground quality and background quality. Now let me take some questions. Prabhu, regarding background mind or subconscious mind, background mind is not subconscious mind. Background mind is a passive conscious mind. Subconscious mind is a source from where the feelings, thoughts, everything, impulses, everything, they are loaded onto the background mind. Okay. So subconscious mind is, you cannot make out. But when you have faith, you have got a background, you have a feeling that you have a faith. In your conscious mind, you have a feeling. When you feel priti, there is a feeling. That means it is in the conscious mind. So the conscious mind itself has two parts. One is where the free will is operating, the foreground mind. And the background mind is where from the subconscious many things have been loaded and it comes into your subconscious mind. If chanting sometimes is more of a pleasant feeling or a kind of happy, enthusiastic feeling, then being servant consciousness does not come. Is that fine? All these small, small questions, you please read very deeply what I am writing in this japa module. There is no one-line solutions to this kind of questions. During daytime, we can apply our knowledge of Krishna conscious philosophy. But what do you do while we are sleeping? How that time we can avoid lusty and scary thoughts? Please practice solutions required. This is not connected to japa. Let me give priority for questions on japa. When I chant, everything around the world comes at that instant in my mind. After chanting, it goes. That is why I say that if you are really interested in chanting, there is hard work to be done. It's not simply some, you know, take on bead and just once in a while chant. Then everything, all these things what you are saying will happen. The most serious thing is getting connected to God. If you are not serious about it. In your life, so many things. If you go on a profession, you are so serious about it. You follow all the norms and, you know, you go to the office at the right time. You do so many things. Then only you get a monthly salary. And as far as japa, perfection of relationship with God, is the greatest asset that you can accumulate in the human form of life. So you have to invest in that. That means systematically read, understand what is being, read these modules, telegram modules. When I start chanting, my quality of chanting improves only from 7th round or 8th round. Why is it happening? Yes, as you associate more and more, you will get strength from the holy name itself to do better rounds. So it's a fact that as you go from first round to 16th round, your later rounds will be of very much better quality than the earlier rounds. Can we chant on Sakshi bead and should we go to and fro on mala, to and fro from mala? You have to chant on the japa mala. And then one 180 is over, you have to go to the next one. You move the next sakshi. Sakshi bead means it keeps the number of rounds that you have completed. We should slowly try to execute this theory module on own or just prepare back, conscious and wait for practical. No, don't wait for practical. The first part of training is what? Preparing your background mind. So these things, if you simply read and think about it, you are preparing your background mind. You are already started quality japa. My training module is only what all you have to do step by step to increase the quality of your foreground chanting. How to hold the attention, all those things I will be explaining in the training module. So this is a training. This japa sessions are right now, the next few sessions and at least till about 25th module, 30, 45 modules that I do, it is all preparing background. And I already again explain to you what is the technique for preparing the background. You have to think, read, understand, grasp and assimilate that knowledge, especially about Savior, who is the Lord. Observe sometimes that devotees shake their head while chanting. Is it to improve concentration? Maybe, maybe not. What is? Once again, once after understanding all the concepts, what if some disturbances make me inattentive at any time? Do you have to read the concepts again? See, all these things, once you understand the concepts, these concepts are in the background. And just now I told you, the foreground chanting is always posing a challenge to us according to different times, kala. You will know, in spite of all the concepts, if your conscious mind is disturbed with something very much, then you will not be attentive. So that means that day you will have to do something more to bring back your attention. So online management of attention is required even if you train yourself. The reason I told you why, because the external situation and our internal psychological situation is different every day. Every day. Sometimes it is very peaceful. Sometimes it can have some, let's say you have fight with somebody, some interpersonal problem. Fully emotionally you are upset. You will not be able to give your attention because every time you take your mala again, you know, oh, I should tell him that. I should reply to him. How I should respond to him. I should handle him like this. These kind of thoughts keep coming. As told in the class, we should not think about anything during japa. Should we keep the photo of Krishna and chant? Okay. And also connected question. As told in class, we should not think about anything during japa. So should I see deity and chant? Yes, there is a statement where Prabhupada says that if you can have the visual of the lotus feet of the deity that you are worshipping, if it naturally comes, then it is very good. But if you are trying to be attentive on the form of the deity, then you are again disconnected from the nama. As a beginner, please understand, you have a higher probability of direct connection with the nama than with the deity form. That is the meaning of saying that Kalikale Namarupa Krishna Avatara. That doesn't mean that deity Archavigraha is not an avatara. In Kali Yuga only Lord is standing in the altar, Radha Krishna Chandra. But that is a very special, easily accessible avatara. To connect with the deity, you need more qualification than being just ordinary. Now, any ordinary man chants, immediately he is in touch with Krishna. As you mentioned, chanting full mala with gratitude, then I get lost in gratitude and attentive japa will not happen. No, one full mala with gratitude means that all the thoughts of gratitude should have already been fed inside. Only the thought feeling should be there, not thoughts that freshly generate gratitude. Okay? Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.